So today what I'm explaining is passive insufficiency, and it's all to do today it's all to do with muscles that stretch over two joints, and what you've got to be aware of when you're doing assessment and treatment. So if we look here, we've got a muscle which is our green ribbon, and it's stretched over two joints. Imagine this is a knee and this is the ankle. So we're looking at it over two joints. Some muscles won't go over two joints, so you'll just have one, and then you'll have a lot more freedom at the moment at the bottom. But when you've got two muscles, you need to be considering if it's on full stretch, what will happen to the muscle, to the joint at the bottom. So when the joint, when the muscle's not on full stretch, there's a lot of movement in this joint. However, when you put the muscle on full stretch, it limits the movement in this joint. So you wouldn't be able to get full range. Where the muscle's off stretch, you're going to get more range and more ability to move it. So when you're assessing, you need to be considering where both joints are. So that's a passive insufficiency. Active insufficiency is the same concept of the same muscle stretched over two joints. But in terms of when that muscle contracts, when it's in the extended position, it doesn't have as much force to contract. So if you look at this muscle and it's trying to work, it doesn't have as much force to contract. Because with it